let me read question first. Find the number of elements of order 2 in S5. Okay, order 2 in S5. So first let me see first step, what to do, how to do. Okay, so this needs some more concentration, so please be attention. Okay, so in the first step, just write the, find out the cardinality of this S5, because our given symmetric group is what? This is a S5. So in the first step, I am going to take the cardinality of this S5. So what is the cardinality? Cardinality that is nothing but what? Of course, yeah, the total number of elements present in the set. So in S5 there are how many? So this is 5 factorial. Okay, the cardinality of S5 is what? Let's see an example. Find the number of elements of order 2 in S5. Okay, so this needs some more concentration, so please be attention for solving this type of questions. So what is our given group? That is a symmetric group. Okay, so first we have to find the cardinality of that SN. For finding the cardinality of SN, so what is the cardinality of SN? Which is nothing but N factorial. Okay, because it is a symmetric group, that's why. If this is simply ZN, then that cardinality of ZN is N. But in the symmetric group, cardinality of SN is what? Which is nothing but N factorial. So now here, my given group is what? That is nothing but S5. So what is the cardinality of this S5, which is nothing but 5 factorial. Okay, so cardinality of this S5 is 5 factorial. Here, what is our N? The given N is what? 5. The given N is what? 5. So first step, you have to write the cardinality and you have to write this N is equal to 5. So after this thing, after this, what you have to do means you have to take a partition of this 5. Okay, so how to take a partition? Partition which is nothing but 5 can be written as, okay, 5 can be written as how many times? We have to check. So first 5 can be written as 5. Okay, so next 4 plus 1. Okay, so next what? 3 plus 2. So next 2 plus 1. Okay, so next 2 plus 2 plus 1. After that what? Yes, 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 gives me 5. So next 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. 1 2 3 4 5. So these all are the partition. Got it? I hope everyone should get this concept right. First you have to find this one. This is a very easy, but this is a bit difficult, but you should remember this thing. Okay, so you have to keep remember this thing. You have to take the partition of this 5. If it is a 7, so then you have to write 7 so you have to take the partition. Okay, so here 5 can be written 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, 6. So after this, what you have to do means you have to take the LCM of these all. I will tell you why. So LCM of 5 gives you, LCM of 5 is how much? 5 only, right? Yes. So I'm just a second. LCM of 5. Okay, so next LCM of 4 comma 1 gives how much? 4. So next LCM of 3 comma 2 gives you how much? 6. LCM which is nothing but least common multiple. So next take the third one, fourth one, 2 comma 2 comma 1. What is the LCM of 2 comma 2 comma 1? That is nothing but 2. So next take this one, LCM of 2 comma 1 comma 1 comma 1. So that gives you a 2. Next LCM of 1 comma 1 comma 1 comma 1 comma 1. So that is nothing but what? 1. Okay, so here half of our work done. So first you have to write n is equal to 5. This is the first step, and second you have to take, this is your second step, and this is what, this is the third tab. So this is your third step. So after this, what you have to do means, see, just look into the question now. So just look into the question. So they are asking of order 2, right? Okay, they are asking of order 2. So now come to here. Here this is the 2 and this is the 2. Only in two lines we get our LCM as 2, right? So now you have to mark these two things. So just mark these two things. This is main important thing. This is, you have to choose this, because in the question they mentioned order as 2. That's why. Okay, in the question they mentioned order as 2. That's why you have to choose these two. Okay, if they asked for finding the order 4, then this is the only, you have, this is the only one option you have to choose. So after this, what you have to do means, after this you have to apply the thing of these two. You have to put these values separately in our formula. Okay, so first I am going to take this one, and second, this is one, and this is one, this is second one. So in the first one, here just write it first here, and because this will get help to you, and this will gives you easy. Okay, so this is what LCM, LCM of 2, 2, 1, which gives you 2. So next you have to apply the formula. What is the formula? We know n factorial. What is our n here? 5 factorial. So next, 1 raised to alpha, 2 raised to alpha, right? So here 1 is there, 1. So only 1 repeats 1 time, therefore here I am going to write 1. So 2 repeats 2 time. Okay, only I have 2 numbers here, so I am going to stop here. Okay, so after this, what we have to do? We have to write, we already seen the formula alpha factorial. So that alpha factorial is, alpha 1 factorial is nothing but 1 factorial into 2 factorial. Okay, this is what, this is a 1 factorial. So just do simplify this one. 5 factorial, which is nothing but what, 120. So next, 1 raised to 1, 2 raised to 4, and this is 1, and this is 2 factorial is also a 1. Okay, so next, 120, otherwise just 2 ones are 260s, right? Yes, 2 ones are and 260s. So next, 2 twos are 230s and 2 ones are 215s. So here we get our answer as 15. This is a, this is where, this is in the type, this is a one first step. So next I am going to write here, there is no space. Oh yeah, so second one, what is the second one? 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Okay, so LCM of this gives me 2, 1, 1 is equal to what? 2. Okay, so just apply the formula up. 5 factorial divided by 1 repeat 3 times. Yes, 1 repeat how many times? 3 times. So next, into 2 repeat only 1 time. 2 repeat 1 time. So 3 factorial into 1 factorial. So 5 factorial is gives me a 120, and this is 1, and 2 raised to 1 is 1, and 3 factorial is 6, and this is 1. So 2 ones are 260s, 6 ones are 610s. Okay, so here I get 10, here I get 15. So now you have to add these two numbers, 10 plus 15, which is nothing but what? 25. So okay, got it. Therefore the number of the, therefore the number of elements, therefore the number of elements of order 2 in S5 are 25. So this is a bit lengthy question. Okay, it will take some time, but if you do more practice, then it will become very easy for you all. Okay, let me revise once. So for finding the number of elements of order 2 in S5. Okay, so what you have to do means just first take the cardinality. Cardinality of this Sn gives you n factorial, and cardinality of S5 is, that's why 5 factorial. So here our n is what? 5. So after this, this is your first. So second, this is a second step. So in the second step, you have to take the partition of this 5. Okay, this is a 5. So 5 can be written as 5, 5 can be written as 4 plus 1, 5 can be written as 3 plus 2, 5 can be written as 2 plus 2 plus 1, 5 can be written as 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. And 5 can be written as 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Okay, so after those, what you have to do means just go to the question. So in question, they are asking the order 2. Okay, order 2. So just check here. So that's why take these all LCM. And look where you get 2 as your answer. Here and here only 2 is visible to me. So that's why you have to choose these 2 options. By choosing these 2, after that what you have to do? You have to apply the formula separately. For this one separately and for this one separately. Okay. So here 2 plus 2 plus 1. So LCM of this 2 gives me 2. Therefore you have to apply the formula. So 5 factorial divided by, here 1 repeats 1 time, therefore 1 raised to 1. Here 2 repeats 2 times, therefore 2 raised to 2. In 2, here in the root I have 1, therefore I am going to write this as a 1 factorial. Here I have 2, so I am going to write here 2 factorial. After this, just do a simplification and you will get your answer as 15. So next move on to second one. Here also I get the LCM of this is a 2, 1, 1, 1 gives me a 2. So after this, by using this data, I'm going to apply these all values in my formula. So finally, I get my answer as 10. So later, you have to add these two things, 15 plus 10. 15 plus 10 gives you 25, right? Yeah, of course. So this 25 is what? This is nothing but the number of elements of order 2 in S5 are how much? 25. So this is the most important question oftenly asking, friends. So do practice. So I gave here only one example. If you want more example, please let me know. I'll give you more. Okay. So let me go to the next topic. Next topic, here just you have to keep remembering these formulas. Some questions are basically depend upon the only formulas, so that's why I am dealing with this thing. So what is the formula and what is the concept? Let us see. Okay, so for finding the characteristic of ring, okay, for finding the characteristic of ring Zn is what? Characteristic of ring Zn is nothing but n. You have to keep remembering this thing, okay? So, characteristic of ring Z is nothing but 1. If your ring is Z, then characteristic of that ring is N. And if your ring is Z, and this is simply 1. So, this question, this type of questions are also asked so many times in exam. If you want, I'll tell you. So let me see an example. First one is, I'm going to write here itself. So first one I'm going to take a Z4. So first one is, first example is what? Z4. Okay, so characteristic of this Z4 is what? Therefore characteristic of Z4 is, which is nothing but what? 4. If you know the formula, you can write it directly. Otherwise, there is a procedure for solving this thing that is waste of time in examination, right? So for exam purpose, we have to keep remember short tricks and short formulas, okay? So next example, I'm going to take a Z7, okay? So for this also, characteristic of character stick of Z7 is what? Which is nothing but seven. Okay, so whatever it is, whether it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 25, 35, whatever it is, just you have to write that number here, and that number gives you a characteristic of ring. Okay, so yeah, in this video I just explained these two things. After this, our next topic is I'm going to solve some questions which were asked in previous year's exams. So, and I chosen those questions. I already uploaded some 5 to 6 videos, I think. So, I'm going to solve the questions depending upon those or concept. Okay, let me start. First question which was asked in Karnataka State Eligibility Test in December 2016. If you want, you can download this question paper in the Google. Otherwise, you can ping me. I'll send the PDF. I have this previous question papers. Okay. So, what is the question? The number of subgroups of cyclic groups of order 20. Okay. So, in the first thing what we have to do in the examination means, after reading the question, otherwise when you start reading, you know, just underline to the keywords. So they're asking for finding the number of subgroups, okay, and what is our order? So that is nothing but 20. So this helps more to you all for solving the question. Okay, so we already learned for finding the number of subgroups, what is the formula? That formula is nothing but tau of n, right? Yes, tau of n is equal to, so I already told this one, I already upload the one video, that 5-in-1 formula. Okay, so you can solve 5 types of question just using this tau of n. So what is this tau of n? Alpha 1 plus 1 and alpha 2 plus 1 and so on up to alpha k plus 1. Okay, so what is this alpha and what is this n means? So here they are asking for finding the order 20, right? So here your n is nothing but what? 20. So here your n is nothing but what? 20. This is your first step. First write the given order. So they are asking for the order 20. So that's why I have written 20. So after this, just express this 20 in the product of prime numbers. So if you don't know for finding that thing, so you just, so our just try this thing, which one method? Division method, by using the help of only prime numbers. 2 times of 10 gives me 20, and 2 times of 5 gives me 10, and 5 times of 1 gives me 5. So now 20 can be expressed as 2 cross 5, right? Yeah. So next, what you have to do means 2 times of 2 repeats 2 times. Then 5 is repeats only 1 time. Okay. So here, this 2 and this 1 gives you, this 2 is what? This is a alpha 1. This is what? This is a alpha 2. Just apply this alpha 1 and alpha 2 in this formula. So here, tau of n, your n is 20, is equal to alpha 1. Your alpha 1 is 2. Okay. Plus 1 into 1 plus 1. So 2 plus 1 gives me 3 into 1 plus 1 gives me 2. So next, 3 times of 2 gives me how much? 6. Okay, so therefore the number of, therefore the number of subgroups, therefore the number of subgroups of cyclic group of order 20 or how many? 6. Okay, if they ask it for finding the order, so what you have to do? So this is most important thing, friends. Just underline the keywords. Okay, that will help to you more for solving the questions in your examination. Okay, so first, this is the formula for finding the number of subgroups. Okay, so not only subgroup, another 4 topics are also there. Okay, that is nothing but subrings, subfield and ideals. Okay, there are totally 5 types of questions you can solve by using this one. Okay, so let us move on to next question. Second question. This question was asked in AP set exam June 2018. AP means Andhra Pradesh set exam. Okay, so let me read the question first. The number of positive divisors of n is equal to 2 raised to 7 into 3 raised to 5 into 5 raised to 3 other than 1 and n is. So what I told you before, so first we have to underline the key points. So they are asking for finding the positive divisors. Okay, so what is the formula for finding the positive divisors? That is also nothing but tau of n is equal to alpha 1 plus 1 and alpha 2 plus 1. So on up to alpha k plus 1. Okay, so here they directly gave to us this one. Okay, so they already represent it in the product of prime numbers. So this they gave as ready-made food here. Okay, this is what, this is a ready-made food. So just we have to apply the formula and we have to tell the answer. First I am going to write a given data. So what is our given data means? N is equal to 2 raised to 7 into 3 raised to 5 into 5 raised to 3. Okay, so we know the formula for this, for finding the positive divisors. That is nothing but alpha 1 plus 1, alpha 2 plus 1 and alpha 3 plus 1. Here only we have 3 numbers, so we get only a 3, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. That's why I stopped till here. Okay, otherwise I'm going to write this whole formula also. Okay, so next. So what is the given name? We don't know. Just leave it. Okay. So what is your alpha 1? That is what? 7 plus 1. And second alpha 2 is what? 5 plus 1. And alpha 3 is what? 3 plus 1. Okay. So next. 7 plus 1 gives me 8 into 5 plus 1 gives me 6 and 3 plus 1 gives me 4. Right? Yeah. So 8 times of 6 gives me 48. Next into 4. 48 times of 4 gives me how much? 192. Okay. So this is what? This 192 is a positive divisors of this one. But they asked another question also. What is that? Other than 1 and n. Other than 1 and n. So means we have to remove the 2 positive divisors for this one. Okay. Why we have to remove 2? Because in the question they mentioned that find the number of positive divisors other than 1 and n. Okay. That's why therefore 192 minus 2. These 2 positive divisors are nothing but that 1 and n. So 192 minus 2 gives me what? 190. Okay. So this is what? This is a total number of positive divisors. Positive divisors. But other than 192. So other than, this is what? 190 means how this is other than 1 and n. How many positive integers? 190. This is your final answer. Okay. I hope this is very easy. But just bit tricky question. So other than that, nothing is doing. This is a very simple. We just apply the formula here. And later just we have to remove these two from total positive divisors. Okay. Let me move on to the next question. Was asked in AP set exam. Okay, so this question is also from AP set, and when this is asked means in 2018 June. Okay, in 2018 June this question was came. So here we have to find the generators of cyclic groups of order 18. Okay, so for finding the generator, what is the formula? If you already seen my all videos, then definitely you can solve this question. Otherwise, I'll tell you how to solve this question. So for finding the generators, we have to apply the Euler function formula. Which one? Euler function formula. So what is that Euler function of formula means? Euler function of n is equal to n into 1 minus 1 by p1 into 1 minus 1 by p2 and so on up to 1 minus 1 by pk. Here these are p1, p2, so on up to pk represent the prime numbers. So here our given order is what? Which is a 18. So first what we have to do means, first we have to express this 18 into the product of prime numbers. Okay, so how to write the product of prime numbers? That is nothing but, so I'm going to divide this 18 by taking only prime numbers. You have to take only prime numbers. 3 times of 3 gives me 9 and 3 times of 1 gives me 3. Therefore 18 can be written as 2 cross 3 cross 3. So here 2 repeats 1 time and 3 repeats 2 times. Right? Yes. So next, so here this is what? This 2 is a P1 and this 3 is what? This is a P2. Just put these values in your formula. So pi of 18 gives you 18 into 1 minus 1 by 2 into 1 minus 1 by 3. Okay, so 18, take LCM which is 2 and 2 minus 1 gives you 1 and this is 3 and 3 minus 1 gives you 2. Okay, so 2 ones are 2 nines are 3 ones are 3 threes are. So answer is what? 6. Therefore, the generators of cyclic groups is what? Order 18 is 6. So in the option they gave as 4 and option B is a 6 and option C I think it is 5. No, option C is a 6 and this is 5. And in question I think D what they gave? That is a 9. So here which is our option? 6 is a correct answer. Okay, so for finding the generator we have to use the Euler function formula. Okay, let us move on to the next question. Fourth question. In the ring Z of integers with usual addition and multiplication, the intersection of the ideals. So here they're asking for us for finding the intersection of the ideals. This is our keyword. Okay, with usual addition and multiplication, and these are our given rings. Okay, so for finding this, what is the trick and what is the formula? Means for finding the intersection of two ideals, you have to take the LCM of those two rings. Okay, what we have to do? Intersection of two ideals, because here they gave only two, that's why I'm going to write here two. If they gave here three, then you have to take here three. If they ask for four, you have to take here four. So what is the formula? Means just take the LCM of the given rings. So here they gave only two rings, so those two rings are nothing but what? 12 and 18. Right? Yes. So now we have to take the LCM of 12 and 18. So that answer gives you what? That answer gives you the, this answer gives you this one, intersection of ideals. Okay, so there are 2 to 3 methods are there for finding this least common multiples. So the very easiest method is, of course, that is the what? Division method. So I'm going to use that one, 12, 18. Okay, so how to do the LCM means just to take prime number here, start with prime number. So 2, 2 6 are 12, 2 9 are 18. Next, 6, 2 times of 3 gives me 6, but 9 does not divide it by 2. Okay, that's why just keep as it is. So next, 2 does not divide 3 or 9, so that's why take 3, because 3 is a prime number. 3 ones and 3 threes. So finally take a 3, keep 1 as it is, and just 3 times of 1 gives you 3. So now LCM. LCM. You have to do what? You have to do the LCM. So for finding the LCM, what you have to do means just multiply these all things. 2 cross 2 cross 3 cross 3. This gives you least common multiple. 2 to the 4 and 3 to the 9. So 4 9 is what? 36. Okay. So this is what your answer is, 36. So let me see the option. Is 36 there in your option or not? Yeah. Sorry, this is a 36. Okay. So here option A is a correct. Let me revise once. If they ask for finding the intersection of the ideas, so just take the LCM of those given rings. Okay. Use the division method for taking the LCM. This is very easy. Okay. So next, let us move on to next question. That is what? Fifth question. Fifth question. Okay. So this question was asked in TS set. TS nothing but that is a Telangana state eligibility test. Okay. So let me read the question. The number of idempotent elements. Okay. What is our keywords here? Number of idempotent elements. It means they are asking to us for finding the number of idempotent elements. Okay. So here given ring is what? That is a Z6. Here our given ring is Z6. Forget these all statements. Leave it. Okay. So just concentrate on this number on idempotent elements and the given ring. So, how to find the number of idempotent elements? What is the formula? That is nothing but 2 raised to d. D means what? The number of prime divisors. Okay. Let me solve the question step by step. What is the given ring? That is Z6. What is the cardinality of that Z6? That is nothing but 6. Therefore, here our n is what? 6. So, now what we have to do? We have to find the divisor of this 6. What are the divisors of this 6? 1, because 1 divides 6 and 2 divides 6 and 3 divides 6 and 4 does not divide, 5 does not, and finally 6 divides 6. So these all are what? These all are the divisors. Okay. So divisors of this 6 is 1, 2, 3, 4. But I don't want all divisors. I just want prime divisors. So here 2 and 3 are the, these are what? These are the only prime divisors. These are the only prime divisors. So I need the number of prime divisors. How many prime divisors are there here? 2 comma 3. It means 1 and 2. So the number of prime divisors, the number of prime divisors, how much? 2. So d, this 2 is what? This is nothing but d. So we know the formula, that is nothing but 2 raised to d. So this 2 raised to d is what? This is a number of idempotent. This gives you a number of idempotent elements, idempotent elements in ring. Okay, idempotent elements in ring. So 2 as it is, what is your d? D is a 2. So 2 raised to 2, which is what? 4. So let me check whether 4 is there or not in our option. Yeah, it is there. Where? In option D. Okay, so in option D. I hope you everyone should understood this one. So this is very simple thing, friends. So almost in set exams, from algebra, they are asking like this type of questions only. So those all were easy, but the thing is that you need to remembering the formulas and just do practice. Okay, so another 2 more questions are there. Let me solve 6th question, which were asked in CSIR NET June 2018. You can go through the question paper. Definitely this question was the ring that, okay. So what is the question? Let me read. The number of homomorphisms. So our key points are what? Number of homomorphism. They are asking to us for finding the number of homomorphism from Z10 to Z20. So if you watched my previous video, that is 6 types of homomorphism, definitely you can solve this one easily. So what is the formula? Yes, that is nothing but GCD. We have to take the GCD. So here our given group is what? From Z10 to Z20. Yes. So for finding the number of homomorphism, we have to take GCD of 10, 20. So what is this GCD? This GCD is nothing but greatest common divisor. So how to take the GCD? If you don't know, just I told in that video also, you can watch that one if you still didn't watch that thing, okay? The link I will give you in the description box. So take the smaller number in the place of divisor and larger number in the place of dividend. Just do divide this one. So 10 times of 2 gives me 20. So here my remainder is 0. When I get my remainder as 0, when there is a divisor is 10. Therefore GCD of 10, 20 is what? 10. Okay, so GCD of 10, 20 is what? 10. So the number of homomorphisms from Z10 to Z20 is what? 10. Look into here. Is 10 is there in the option? Yeah. In the fourth option it is there. Okay. So just look at here friends how simple it is. This question is asked where? In a CSI NET exam. I told you right. This type of questions are asking again and again in the your examination, whether it may be SAT, NET or any competitive mathematics exam. So just recall the formulas again and again. And you can definitely, you will solve these types of questions. So last but not least, let me see. Last question, question number 7. Important question. This is also asked in a previous year's questions. But I forgot when they asked. So just look at here. Let me read the question. Let S7 denote the group of permutations of the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Which of the following is true? Okay. So they are asking to us. There is a 4 options. So in this all 4, which is the true? We have to find this one. So what is the in option? There are no element of order 6. There are no elements of order 7. So here there is a no element. So they are mentioning elements and of order. So first here what we have to do means, first we have to find the orders of the 7. Okay. So we know how to find the order of the 7. So this is what? This is nothing but S7. So here my N is what? 7. So first just I will write here. Okay. N is equal to 7. So for finding the orders, how to find? First we have to take partition, okay? Partition. So 7 can be written as 7 and 6 plus 1. Next 5 plus 2. Okay? So next 4 plus 3. Right? Yeah. So next what? 4 plus 2 plus 1. So next 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, so next 4 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Okay, so next 3 plus, yes, 3 plus 3 plus 1. Okay, so next 3 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3, 4, yeah. So next what? 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So, here. So, first I am going to write here. Partition of 7. Take LCM. So, LCM of 7 gives you how much? 7. Next, LCM of 6, 1 is what? 6. And LCM of 5, 2 is what? Which is a 10. And LCM of 4, 3. Okay. So, LCM of 4, 3 is what? This is a 12. So, next, this gives you LCM is what? LCM of 4, 2, 1 is 4. Yes. So, next, this is what? LCM of 2, 1 is what? 2. So, next, this is a LCM of 4, 1, 1 is what? This is a 4. And LCM of 3, 3, 1 gives you 3. So, next, this is also, this gives you 3 and this gives you what? 1. So, these all are what means? So, this 7, 6, 10, 12, 4, 2, 4, 3, 3, 1. So, these all are what? So, these all are, nothing but orders of your S7. Okay? So, these all are what? These all are the orders of this S7. So, now we will read the option. We will check which one is true or not. There are no element of order 6 in S7. This is wrong because there is a element, okay? Because here just here it is a order 6 is there. So, that's why if we have order 6, definitely we have a number of elements here, okay? So, some elements are there and those elements have our order 6. So, that's why this is not our correct option. So, this is a false and there are no elements of order 7. Yeah, no, because some elements are there which is having order as 7. So, second option is also wrong. There are no elements of order 8. Yes, we don't have order as 8 here, right? So, that's why this third one is a what? Correct option. There are no elements of order 10. No, because we have order here 10. So, if we have we already have a order means what? We also have some elements. Okay, for finding the number of elements having this order, you can watch my previous videos, guys. Okay, so I think this one will get clear to you, right? So, nothing is there. First, I do partition and after that, I just take a LCM. So, answer of this is gives you orders of this S7. Okay, so later just check whether I have order 6 or order 7 and also have order 10. But there is no orders as 8 here. That's why there is no elements. There is no elements of order 18, S7. Okay. I hope this video get helps to you more. And if you like the video, give a big thumbs up and do share and comment also. And if you are new to my channel, do subscribe for more videos and for more updates. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video.